Round 21 for Virgil Ortiz, and he's going strong like round one.
It's the only way.
Working hard. Hard work, dedication. Virgil, is uppercut the hardest punch to throw in boxing?
The what?
Uppercut?
If it's the hardest punch?
Yeah. Because look, the straight right, the jab, the hook, those are easy, right?
No, I think the hardest punch for most people to throw is the body punch because they don't know how to throw it. A lot of people do not know how to throw a body punch. They're just slaps.
They're slappers?
They're slap. No, seriously, they slap. A lot of people slap, but they don't know how to throw it. And since a lot of people don't know how to throw it, that means there's also a lot of people that don't know how to teach it. So when they see it, like the judge sees it, a lot of judges count a body punch unless it pretty much hurts the guy, and they don't realize what a good body punch, what it is. I've seen people throw a bunch of body punches in a fight and actually watch USA officials. We're talking about USA officials in the amateur game. Talking about, oh, look at all those body punches, man, he's winning the fight. And the guy's blocking all the punches. And I'm thinking, this is why our amateur program's where it's at, because these guys don't even understand what an actual punch is that's landing, or that's not landing, or that's being blocked.
That's a problem in judging.
I mean, the win is based on people's opinion.
That's why it's good what Virgil's doing. Don't leave it in the judge's hands, Virgil.
We're trying not to leave it in the judge's
hands. 16-0, 16 knockouts.
We just do our job, but I mean, still, one day it'll go to decision, and we just hope it, you know, that is what it is.
How many rounds today?
Maybe he's probably got about nine more.
Nine more? Wow.
Well, he's doing 30. We should do about 30 rounds.
30 rounds a day, is that normal? You feel okay? Most fighters do 14, 15, 16, 20.
Yeah, those guys don't go anywhere.
That's true.
They're
the Mamba mentality. Work hard. Virgil trains 6 and 7 days a week, 30 rounds a day. You only fight 12 rounds, right?
Yeah.
But that's
only 12 rounds.
If it goes
that way.
What's the most rounds you ever fought in the pros?
7.
Against Sammy Vargas?
Sam Vargas, yeah.
He was tough, but they could have stopped that fight after 4 or 5.
They should have stopped it after 4.
But it's good. It's good to put in some rounds.
Yeah, but he took a lot of unnecessary punishment. He wasn't gonna get caught winning that fight.
You think when he attacked him, he should have been called a knockdown?
Because he should have took a point. You know that. He could have hurt you.
Yeah.
He could have hurt you.
Like that video?
Yeah. Oh, shoot. I don't even want to think about that one.
What are you talking about?
There's a video where a guy's doing backyard wrestling and his knees.
Both
they go in. They go in. He folds forward.
They fold the wrong way. Both.
That's crazy. But I think Tank had knockout of the year.
Yeah, he had a good knockout. Nice upper. You know what that uppercut reminded me of? That same uppercut reminded me of when Devin Alexander knocked out Orango. I don't know if you ever remember that.
Long time ago.
The Colombian guy?
Yeah.
He winded up some uppers, and he picked the guy up off the ground. The guy went to sleep. That was the exact same knockout. Damn, I can't remember.
Yeah, but Tank did against Leo. Leo's never been stopped in 39 fights.
But Leo does this. The small guy compared to him.
They both made 130, they both made weight.
Yeah, no.
So
but
I'm not gonna.
Naturally is what I mean.
But physically, he's taller than him. And Tank turned pro 26.
At 26?
How old is he? 26.
Oh.
But I'm saying he turned pro at 126.
Oh, I thought he said he was 26.
Yeah, I was like, goddamn.
No, he turned pro at like 17, 18.
Yeah.
He was champ after 16 fights. He beat Pedraza, who went on to go the distance with Loman, become a champ at 135. Let's see, him and Ryan will be a big fight, Virgil. You also gonna be ringside when that happens?
Yeah, if we can afford it.
Well, hopefully your son's on the card as well. It's a big, big pay-per-view fight.
Yeah, that's a good fight.
Imagine him and Crawford on the same card.
Oh, that would have to be its own main event.
Yeah, Crawford versus him.
That's his own pay-per-view.
Especially because Crawford's he's one of the guys up there. He would never.
Okay, Virgil and Keith Thurman, is that a pay-per-view fight?
I think it's borderline. I think it's borderline.
I think it is.
With a little extra help with somebody under there, because you know all the guys like May and all that at the beginning and all that, they all had a deep.
It's true.
I remember when Mayweather fought somebody, I forgot who it was. And I was like, and then they put in Danny Garcia versus Luke Matisse.
Yes.
On the undercard.
Yep.
Now, that's worth buying.
Was it Guerrero? I think so. Mayweather Guerrero.
See, no, who was gonna buy that?
Would you like to fight Robert Guerrero right now?
I don't get anything out of
that. He's a 5-time champ, 6-time champ?
I don't get anything out
of that. Yeah, but I don't think Virgil earns anything. Whoa, I think he's already too...
Your son told me the three names he wants to fight. Danny Garcia, Sean Porter, and Terrence Crawford.
That's good. That
means those are all champion-caliber fighters.
That means he wants to be the best. He's not just... Again, wanting a fight is not like calling people out.
That's good. And it looks like it's Maurice Hooker. Not official, but it looks like it's Maurice Hooker. Yeah. Big fight, too.
Yeah, that's a good fight, too. Maurice can fight.
This is Murataya's bag.
Yeah, it's gonna snap pretty soon.
Hey, what happened to your bag here? Your uppercut.
I need to buy a bungee.
It's on its way. It's on your ship.
Order ship.
Very ship. Okay.
Let me ask you this. Do you think Canelo could be the greatest Mexican fighter ever in the end of the day when he retires?
Yeah.
Why?
Because of everything he's done. I mean, you can say all you want about Chavez and about all the other guys. You know who's the other guy who, my personal opinion, who is the greatest? I don't think Chavez is the greatest. I think he might be like the second. Salvador Sanchez, was the greatest when he was young. But look at
Azuma Nelson, fighter of the year.
He fought everybody.
Super young, yeah.
You know, for the world title, and he beat a bunch of Hall of Famers at a young age. But of course, you know, he died early with 45 something fights. But I think Canelo, because he's dominating the sport at his time. He's not just sitting at just one weight and just. He knows he can
babysitting it, yeah.
Yeah, he's not babysitting it.
Four division champ?
He's fighting bigger guys. It's not easy fighting bigger guys. And I don't care, you know, people can say all they want. Oh, well, the guy did a hydration clause, this and that. Nobody makes anybody sign anything. What if the guy wins, then what?
Yep.
The guy's bigger?
Look what he did to Liam Smith, Colin Smith.
Yeah, but I would say he's pretty much, he's there. I think Canelo's pretty much almost there. He's like a Manny Pacquiao. Look what Manny Pacquiao is doing.
Eighth division champ?
You know,
and he's still fighting.
He might have lost to May, but his career doesn't compare to that.
Okay,
Virgil, just better.
What do you think of Pacquiao Spence? Manny said he has two fights in mind, Spence and McGregor.
Well, McGregor, obviously, that's just to...
It's a big money fight. He said he's going to donate money to COVID victims in the Philippines.
That which is good. It just depends on Manny Pacquiao. You just never know, man. I mean, look, he's old, but he's still young. His old could be a lot of people's prime.
Like they said about Chick Curran, the Lakers announcer, he may have lost a step or two, but he's still 10 ahead of everyone else.
That's what I'm saying. Like his old might be someone else's prime.
Yeah. He's special. He's always in shape. He's like Virgil. You know Manny Pacquiao does 2,600 sit-ups a day?
2,600?
Yeah.
I've never passed 1,000.
No, he does 1,300 in the morning. He has his routine. But I'm saying he's always in shape.
Pita,
how many sit-ups do you do a day? Yeah, Manny Pacquiao does 2,600 a day.
Good for him. I don't do any.
Good for him.
But if you did do them, how many did you do?
Nothing.